Hello, this is Trevor, and today I'm going to show you how to create a Faceit for your character with Faceit Addon, so you can resize the necessary ARKit shape piece for your
facial motion capture. I'm going to cover some
possible errors you might face
and how to solve them.
Also, we are going to use these shape keys or in other names, morph targets in Unreal for gameplay and for cinematic purposes in later videos, so stay tuned for those. With that said, it's going to be an easy tutorial, so let's get started. Let's address it first, that Faceit is a paid addon, but if you're into character facial animation, in my opinion, it's definitely a must-have. It not just creates you ARKit shape keys, it saves you from a lot of annoying gray painting. If you ever did face rigging with Rigify, for example, you should know the pain. So it's totally worth the price, and I really recommend it. With that said, let's start this now. Okay, so here we got our character, I got some piercing, and I created the inner mouse, for which, again, I used the free asset bundle and modified it a bit to make it more game-ready. Let me just hide my main rig for now. Select all your meshes that you want to use for facial animation. It can be one mesh or separated meshes as well, but I prefer and recommend it in a separate way to avoid any errors at the haircuts. I will talk more about that later in the video. Now in the Faceit tab, let's just hit Register Face Objects. Now this menu will pop up. We have two picker options, Surface and Object. In case of single separated mesh, we can go and use Object. I will show you the Surface one as well in a bit. First, register our main, which is our character. Now that it is registered, with this eye icon, we can see what we did register. If we exited the EQ that something we don't want, then we can easily see it here. Now with this icon, we can mask the area, and with pushing this button, we can hide it, so it will not be in our way. If you want to unhide it, just click this icon back. Now let's select the eye, but now use this picker option. Currently we are in object selection mode, we can pick objects obviously, but if you change this to surface, now we can select individual parts of the registered mesh. For example, individual hair cards, as you can see, or part of the eye, but we don't want that now, so I switch back to object and click on the right eye. Now that if you are done, just press enter. Now select the other eye, but now just use this simple button this time. Let me hide this. And let's see the next part, the mouth. Now this one is a single mesh in my case, and this is when surface option becomes handy. Let's use the picker option and select the upper teeth parts, which should be the upper gum and the upper teeth. Let me hide this. Let's do the same with the lower one as well, but this time let's do this in edit mode. I'm using L to simply select UV islands here. After selection is done, I can go back to object mode and now it's registered as lower teeth. Now, don't be confused by this masking. If you just press the first icon, it will show you the masked part. To hide it as well, use this other icon as well. Otherwise, your unassigned parts will be not visible. In my case, the unassigned parts is the tongue. Let's use the picker option again. Click on it, then hit enter to register. Okay, it's done, let's hide it. Next one, eyelashes. Let's see what happens if I try to apply multiple brushes to this group. As you can see, it gives you an error. It doesn't matter if you are in surface or object mode, it will give you an error. I guess this is due to a fact to avoid accidental errors, but just remember, you can't assign multiple objects at once. Now an important tip, so the reason I told you I prefer that my parts are separated like this is due to the fact that as I experienced in my other face rigs a few times, if you try to apply hair cards with the surface method, it can give you an error later when the addon try to create the weight painting. Basically it will or may give you our all-time favorite bone heat error. That said, it doesn't mean it wouldn't work for you 100% of the time, but it's just my experience. Now let's add them one by one. Now for the tear ducts, it's not specifically mentioned here, but you see here is tear line. Tear line is a different thing, but I don't have that here. If you have, you can apply it here obviously, but if you have tear duct like I have here, you should apply it here. Or another great version is to leave them unassigned, but I found that this gives you the best result. Again, hide this. Next up, facial hair. Now we only have eyebrows, but beards should belong here as well. In my time elapse video for my other character, I used that as well. In case you want to check that, I leave a link here. Okay, let's assign them one by one. Hide them. Let's assign the hair as rigid and the piercing as well. Let's unhide everything now. And let's head for the next step, which is called rig. Now, let's hit the generate landmark, and if your character is far away like mine here, and the face landmark is huge like this, don't be freaked out, it will scale it down automatically. Just make sure you place it to the chin, like I am doing here. Now we just need to align it with the face. Once it's done, we need to apply these dots to the right location. It's almost perfect, but we need some tweaking. This needs to be at the tip of the chin. This one should be a bit lower than the chin. This should be the chin end, jaw end. This one under the ears. With this, we can mask out the other parts, so only our main group will be visible. These inner mouth ones should be inside of the lip, not outside. But you can always come back to this part later if you feel that the deformation is not as you want it. These ones should be a bit outside of the mouth. At the eyes, the two edges should be a bit more outside of the eyes. The three lower and upper ones should be sitting on the actual lids of the eye. This one should be right above the eye. Try to align it to this crease of the character. These ones are the eyebrow ones, and these ones defining the end of the forehead. Let's align this a bit more to the cheeks. This one to the end of the nose below. These are the nostrils, and the middle one is the tip of the nose. They are looking good now, so let's hit project landmarks. Now if you get some problems like me here, just push this back to the character. Let's refine this just a tiny bit more. For the mouth, you should turn off snapping and push it under the skin just a little. And at the eyes, do the same, but it's enough if you just push the two ends of the edges under the skin. For this lowest one, try to align it like me, just a little bit below the chin. And let's just place this more to the end as well. Now it's done, let's generate the face rig. Now just hit OK, we don't need those two options. Now the next one is bind. Now these options here will most probably will need to be tweaked. This is the part where the Addon will create the necessary weight painting data for our mesh. I mentioned that hair cards can sometimes cause errors or bone heat wave basically. Now if it does, this will be the place we need to do some changes. First, let's just see what it does and maybe I can get away with it without an error. No, we did not. As you can see below, Faceit binding failed, see console for more info. You can check the console here, under window, toggle system console. But I already know what it writes. It says that the scale factor should be higher. So let's just see these options. Click on show advanced options. It's looking a bit intimidating, but I already experimented with all of these settings and what they do, so you don't have to. And what really makes difference is these two setups. The first one is obviously the mentioned scale factor, so crank that up to 1000, or you can try it with a lower value if you want to. And the other one is this weight method. So change this to transfer instead of auto. Now on my understanding what it does, it basically transfers the weight from the area that is behind the hair cards to the hair cards. So even if there is no exact interaction, for example between the eyebrow and the forehead, it still gives the weight paints of the corresponding forehead part. Because these errors are happening usually due to the fact that one or more cards are not intersecting with the character properly, or only barely. Therefore Blender not sure what to do with these parts, and that's why the errors occur. Now regarding the scale factor, with the scale factor we increase the radius of the weight paint transfer. 1000 should cover all the necessary parts now. There is even an option here, transfer for hair only. This can also make a difference if you are still receiving errors after this. You can tick that and try it with that as well. The error can be also caused by the fact that I mentioned in the setup part, which is if you apply the hair cards with surface and not as an object. So even after all this, you still get errors. Try separate the hair card to individual mesh, like mine here, and then try to apply it. Okay, now let's hit that OK button now. And now it's all working. Let's test this in pose mode. I mean, look at that, this is why I use it. The weight painting job that this Addon does is extremely great. To get this level with Rigify is through extreme pain of weight painting, and even after all, I still always ended up using corrective shape keys. So I really emphasize that this Addon is a must-have. It saves you a ton of time and headache. I mean, Todor, aka CG Dive, said it really proficiently and professionally.
Even the eye works out of the box, and if you've used default Rigify, you know that this is quite an accomplishment.
but I'm not a professional, so I just say it does an unbelievably f***ing great job. But jokes aside, I would like to mention his CGI videos on Faceit Addon, because he's a go-to guy if you want to know rigging in depth, whenever if it is Faceit or any kind of rigging process. I have to mention him always when it comes to rigging tutorials of mine, because I really think he explains everything extremely great, and if you didn't receive the info you are looking for here, you definitely will there. Feel free to check out his YouTube site, I will leave a link down below in the description. Okay, let's move on. Next is expressions. Just load the expressions, click on this. We need the ARKit for games, so I'm going with that. Now in this part you can modify the shape keys if they are not quite right. There's a great guide on this side on how these shape keys should look, so just check it side by side, but 90% of it will be just fine. There's one little trick you can use, is to tick preserve volume in the Faceit rig, because when we bake these, we will bake the entire modifier to the mesh, so we will be able to keep that. What this preserve volume does, if you are not familiar with it, it gives you a better deformations. You can also add a smooth corrective modifier here, which can also be baked to the mesh, improving the deformations even further. Let me just quickly run through these. They are quite good. Usually the smiles can be a bit off or weird, but you can modify the stereo hard content. Okay, now let me show you an example. So what I will do is, I will sculpt some correction on this. What this will does is it will create a corrective shape keys for us that we can later delete, but it's important that you should use this sculpt icon here and not go directly to sculpt node. I will show you why in a second. Now you can see the shape key already created. Now let's make a quick modification to make this more defined and realistic. Okay, now it's done, just go to object mode, and I will try to mirror it. Now we receive some error, that it wasn't successful. It will does a lot of cases unfortunately, but don't worry, we will do it manually. But you really should look out here for the shape keys, because now that I wanted to mirror this, it created a shape key, even though it failed. So now what happened is that it just added the exact sculpt data to the right blink eye as well, which we definitely don't want, because now if the left eye blinks, then it will create double the amount that we sculpted. So to prevent that, just delete the right click shape key, and now we're left with the original that we set it up. Now you can see the shape key, eye blink left, acting as it should be, meaning it's 0 when the right eye blink, and 1 when the corresponding left eye blink. Now let's make the right eye blink now, but first let me show you that why is it a problem if you go simply into sculpting. As you can see, nothing is happening, so it does not give us a shape key, and that's not what we want. Okay, let's modify this in a correct way with the icon. Okay, seems good. Let's go to the next section, baking. Now here are the modifiers we want to bake. I usually join this to the body. I'm going to show you that method as well, but first we will do it without it, so you can see the difference. Take the modifiers you want to bake, in our case Faceit, add corrective mode. So let's hit bake shape keys, keep active, we'll keep the modifiers active, we'll remove, remove them. Action, we don't need action test, currently we don't need to keep Faceit rig active. Now hit OK. Now our rig disappeared and we're left with the shape keys. Let's check them. Don't get scared by the fact that if your mesh parts doesn't move with the main part, it's happening because the mesh parts currently doesn't have any relation to each other, as you can see. If I open the mouth, then the teeth and everything does not come with it. That's perfectly normal, and this is not a problem at all. If you would now import this whole mesh with the eyebrows, hair, lashes and everything to Unreal, it would work perfectly, because unless you are not specified at Unreal's import settings, Unreal will use this as one simple mesh, so the shape keys would work together as they should. Here in Blender, if you would now join the parts, they would act together as well without a problem. Although for optimizing it to Unreal, we would need to purge the vertex groups to the bare minimum and delete unnecessary bone layers, but I will get to that in another video. Now let me just show you what I mentioned earlier, which is you can delete the corrective shape keys because we don't need them. As you can see, if I would crank this up to 1, then it would double it again. So the other builded this correction into the actual eye blink ARKit shape. Now let's go to the next one here. You can modify the ARKits even more if you would want to, but I'm usually not using this. It can just make your expressions more exaggerated or less exaggerated. Now if you only want to use this in a game engine, other than purging vertex groups and bone layers, you are good to go now. But let's be honest, we will need to modify face motion captures, because even this day and age, they are still not perfect and far from it. So that's why we need a control rig, so we can tweak the motion capture values. And it also recreates the connection between separated parts of the mesh. So for that, hit generate control rig. You can leave the values like this. Just for side note, connecting drivers can be turned off later as well. Let's hit OK. And now we have an awesome control rig. And as you can see, it's working as expected. Here you can disconnect the drivers if you want to, and you can reconnect them again. Yellow error, we don't bother. As you can see, it's working again. Now there is a button here, set child off, which is a great tool, because as you can see, currently if I move the original rig, then the control rig will not move with it, which is weird. So if you try to set child off, like simply pressing the button, it gives you an error, because it needs specific bone selected to be parented with. For that, you need to go to pose mode and select the head bone and then hit set child off. And now if I move it, it moves with it. Will is great. I'm usually do it in a different way, because I want this one as well to move with it, because currently this part of the control rig is not following the head. However, I think it should. So there is an easy fix of mine for this. So let's just undo the parenting. Okay, it's done. Select the control rig, go to object constraints, and we are going to add a child off here instead. Select your armature, select the head bone, then it's going to disappear to the abyss, so just hit set inverse, now it's all good. And now if we check it, it moves with it correctly. I think it's just way better this way. So yeah, this is for the first method. Now let me show you my preferred method. So we are back in time now, so let's just use the join body this time. Now this is kinda semi-destructive, since I like to be true to myself, I'm going with it. It automatically detects that I have an existing rig and even registers the head bone, so I can just hit join body and hit OK. Now the two rigs are one now. And now let's bake it. We will keep it active again and set action to not again. And now we must enable this keep faceit rig active, otherwise our whole rig would disappear. Now hit OK. And now I have a face rig with my armature. I have my shape keys. I'm going to delete these corrective ones. Now let's dot that with the control rig. Let's give this a constraint again, just like before. And now both should be working as intended. This method can be confusing, so therefore I'm not really recommending it, but this method can give you a lot more control over your face area. For example, the tongue here or other areas where the control rig lacks of features. This method is not game ready in any means, it's for cinematic purposes only, since obviously we can't use complicated face rig in a game engine, but we can, and I will downgrade this to a game ready rig in later videos. If you are interested in that, I can make the video sooner than I planned, just let me know in the comments down below. So that's all for today, I hope you find it helpful. If you did, please leave a like, subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.